In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. O God, who gladden us year by year with the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, graciously grant that by celebrating these present festivities, we may merit through them to reach eternal joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Easter season is a beautiful time of year to receive the sacrament of confirmation, this gift of the Holy Spirit. Of course, any season of the year is a beautiful time to receive the sacrament of confirmation, but especially at Easter now, still in the glow of Easter Sunday, just a few days ago. Because it is the risen Christ, of course, risen from the dead, who first bestowed the Holy Spirit upon the apostles at Pentecost, which we will be celebrating next month. So the glow of this Easter season, of course, the risen Christ is here once again to bestow now upon his modern disciples in this 21st century to give the Holy Spirit once again to do his work in the world today. Why did Jesus send the Holy Spirit to the church? Why did the Holy Spirit have to come? Well, the clue is right there in the scripture itself when Jesus is addressing the apostles before he takes his leave of them. And he says, wait here in Jerusalem until you receive the promised gift of my Father, and then you are to be my witnesses. In Jerusalem, throughout Judea, and even to the ends of the world. And so that one word really is the key to understanding the gift of the Holy Spirit and confirmation. You are to be his witnesses. Everywhere you go, with that strength and power and holiness of the Holy Spirit now that you carry within you, to do the Lord's work now in this century, just as the apostles received the gift of the Holy Spirit then to do the Lord's work at that time, to spread the gospel message, to spread the life of the church throughout the entire world. So it is a big responsibility that you are undertaking to agree to be a confirmed Catholic, to be Jesus' witnesses. In other words, to be his representatives in the world, or to be his ambassadors in the world. Because people don't see Jesus today, he has ascended to heaven, and he is waiting to come at the end of time, and in the meantime, he depends upon his witnesses, you and I, his representatives, his ambassadors, to be continuing his work of salvation, to be spreading the good news and bringing his hope, his good news, his salvation to all peoples. And that's your job now as confirmed Catholics, as you are completing your sacraments of initiation that began at baptism, and then the Holy Eucharist you've already received, and now the sacrament of confirmation. So remember that word, which sums up all of what you're doing this morning and that you're preparing for. Father mentioned that you have been doing some apostolic works, some works to bring Christ's love, to bring Christ's presence to others. That's being a witness, you're practicing to be a witness. And now you're undertaking that responsibility at your home to be a witness for Christ, witness for Jesus. At your school to be a witness for Jesus. In your neighborhoods, here at church, by your showing up on Sunday for Mass, that's a powerful witness that Jesus is important to you, that Christ is first and foremost in your life, to be, at the very least, here at church on Sundays or at the Saturday evening Mass. So important, because the world as we know, there is so much darkness, there is so much confusion. Jesus really needs to be present out there in this world. It needs Jesus. And because it needs Jesus, Jesus, you need to be consciously, faithfully representing him in your words, in your behavior, in your actions. Everything you say, everything you do should say to people that you're a follower of Jesus, that he is important to you, Jesus Christ. Now there's one word in this gospel today, and as you see, the white vestments of what being worn, because all this week the church is celebrating in the glow of Easter, continuing to celebrate the Easter festival. And so even though confirmation is celebrated today and on Friday, we're still going to be wearing white, and the readings and the prayers will recall the great blessing of Easter. And there's one line in today's gospel where the two disciples are on their way to Emmaus. They're going walking away from Jerusalem, and Jesus comes to walk with those two disciples. And as they're walking along and evening is beginning to come, Jesus pretends like he's going to keep on walking further while they're going to stop and go into the town of Emmaus. And those two disciples say to Jesus, "Stay with us. Stay with us. We enjoy so much being with you." And those are some words that you can take with you from your confirmation mass in your own heart, to be saying to Jesus, "Stay with me. Jesus, stay with me. I know you will be with me, but help me always to be conscious and aware of your presence. And give me the grace so that I might always open my heart to you. Stay with me, Jesus. In good times and in bad, when I'm having difficulties or distress or problems, or even when everything seems to be going right, don't let me stray away. Stay with me, Jesus." That's what the disciples say in this gospel today on Easter Sunday afternoon when they were speaking to the risen Christ. Just imagine that. The risen Savior in his glorified humanity is there walking along with them. And they say those beautiful words, "Stay with us." Of course he will, but you have to make sure your heart is always open to receive him and welcome him and to keep him there with you. Now, I would like for you confirmation students, please, to stand in your place. Thank you.
peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Thank you.
Peace be with you.
Thank you.
Peace be with you.
We pray, O Lord, that the reverent reception of the sacrament of your Son may cleanse us from our old ways and transform us into a new creation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bishop Peter, we're very grateful for you to come here during the Easter season, and I appreciate your words of how the joy of Easter really radiates towards these wonderful youth who are going to be the future of the church. And so we're very happy to have you here. And thanks for your guidance for us and for the whole diocese.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace, do love, and serve the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Please join us in singing number 777.